With the future of the economy at stake, the Federal Reserve needs new thinking. Hello, I'm Steve Forbes, and this is What's Ahead, where you get the insights you need to help navigate this turbulent world. It gets virtually no notice in the news, given hurricanes, horrific fires, the presidential election, and the COVID crisis. But the Senate will soon decide whether Judy Shelton gets confirmed as a governor of the Federal Reserve. She was nominated for a vacant seat several months ago by President Trump. If confirmed, Dr. Shelton would be one of seven governors and one of 12 members of the Critical Policymaking Open Market Committee. She would be one voice among many. She would hardly be running the place. Yet the Fed and its numerous supporters in the media, the academic world, and Congress are waging a bitter, smear-ridden campaign to derail our nomination. Why? She has the academic credentials. She's immensely knowledgeable about monetary policy. Her sin is not her qualifications, but rather she does not blindly accept the way the Federal Reserve operates or the way it views the world. Clearly, the Fed can't tolerate real diversity in opinion and outlook. For example, the Federal Reserve accepts as holy writ what is called the Phillips curve. The curve posits that if you want low unemployment, you must have high inflation. Conversely, low inflation means high unemployment. Of course, real-world experience now and in the past has demonstrated the Phillips curve is nonsense. Even though seven Nobel Prize-winning economists have debunked this theory, the Fed clings to the idea that prosperity causes inflation. Judy rightly thinks printing too much money is the real culprit. She is also skeptical of the notion that the Fed can precisely guide the performance of an economy as immense and complex as that of the U.S. Again, the Fed's record here justifies such caution. What also irks the Fed and most economists is that Judy Shelton has had nice words to say about the gold standard the U.S. successfully had from the days of George Washington and Alexander Hamilton in the 1790s until the early 1970s, when, through a series of blunders, we went off of it. To be blunt, the gold standard critics here don't know what they're talking about and are victim of numerous myths. More to the point, only Congress, not the Federal Reserve, can enact a new gold standard, and there's no prospect of that. The legendary economist Joseph Schumpeter observed that the key for change is asking the right questions. That's what the Federal Reserve really fears. Judy Shelton has the knowledge and strength of character to ask the right questions, and that makes the Fed extremely uncomfortable. But such discomfort is needed. With the COVID-19 crisis, the Federal Reserve has become more powerful than ever, which makes Judy's presence more crucial than ever. I'm Steve Forbes. Thanks for listening. Do send in your comments and suggestions. I look forward to seeing you next time.